Hi everyone. So as you've probably seen, this is sold out just about everywhere. And so aside from making hand sanitizer yourself or buying it on the black market, how are you able to protect yourself during this outbreak? Well, I want to talk to you about five natural ways that you can supplement and boost your immune system that are actually backed by research. Hi, I'm Dr. Sarah Bennett. I'm a licensed naturopathic physician and co-founder of Natural MedDoc. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about five natural ways to support your immune system that are actually backed by research. So more specifically, we're going to be talking about zinc, vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin C, and certain strains that are found in probiotics. But before we get started, if you're watching from YouTube, hit the subscribe button and share this with a friend that might find it useful. All right, so first we have zinc. And what you need to know about this is that it helps decrease the viral yield, meaning that the virus is not proliferating, it's not replicating at the speed that it would. And it's really important for this one that you actually supplement before you get sick. Once you get sick, it's only gonna do so much for you. But what they find as far as why this helps to decrease the yield is because the virus is not able to penetrate the cell wall nearly as well. And they think it's because it's not able to actually bind to that cell wall. So next we're going to talk about vitamin C, and this one is probably most commonly found in people's medicine cabinets for times when they get sick. But what you don't realize is that you should probably be taking this daily to help prevent your susceptibility or decrease your susceptibility to these infections. So research has shown that vitamin C insufficiency and deficiencies increase your susceptibility to not only viral infections, but bacterial infections. So what that means is that you should be taking in at minimum 200 milligrams of vitamin C a day. And that will sufficiently decrease that susceptibility, as well as if you happen to get sick, decrease the severity of symptoms. So what happens if you get sick and you haven't been doing this? You should actually take quite a bit more than 200 milligrams. Research shows that it's about 100 or 1,000 milligrams or more per day that's going to help you out at that point. What that does for you is decrease the severity of symptoms and the duration of symptoms. So it can actually help you to recover more quickly. So next we have vitamin A. This one may be a little less common to see in somebody's medicine cabinet, but actually it's very important for support of your immune function. So vitamin A insufficiency and deficiency has also been related to increased susceptibility of infections. Actually, it's been related to increased mortality rates to respiratory infections and GI infections. So what does vitamin A do for us? Basically, it increases our lymphocytic migration. And that means that your white blood cells or your immune fighters are going to be able to travel to the locations that they need, that they're needed more readily. Also, our intestines house a very intricate immune system, and it helps with something called IgA production in this location. So it really helps increase our immune function from our GI system, which directly helps to fight these infections and prevent us from getting them. And so now we have vitamin D. And this is one that I very, very frequently see my patients come back deficient in. Actually, it's so important for us in so many different ways that I have actually made a video dedicated solely to vitamin D. So go and check that one out if you're interested in a little more information in this area. But vitamin D in relation to our immune system, if we're deficient, just like the other vitamins, we're going to be more susceptible to infections. But research has actually shown that a therapeutic daily dose of vitamin D can decrease the incidence of flu by up to 42%. That's huge. So what does it do for us? Well, it helps to regulate our immune cells, our B cells and our T cells, as well as regulate our cytokine production. So it flips it from a pro-inflammatory production to more of an anti-inflammatory production. Really what you need to know about this is it increases the efficacy of your immune system. So lastly, we're gonna talk about probiotics. These are basically live bacteria that you supplement that go in and coat the lining of your GI tract. And the type that you're supplementing actually go in and help your gut flora to be healthy, and just like vitamin A, help to support this immune system that our GI tract houses. So I want to talk to you about two very common species found in these probiotics. First, there's the lactobacillus, and this one has been shown to decrease incidence of infections such as the common cold. It also has been shown to alleviate symptoms found in infection from things like the flu. The other species that I want to talk to you about is called Saccharomyces boulardii. And this one is found a little less frequently in most probiotics, but you'll still be able to find it. And just like vitamin A, it helps to improve the production of IgA. And that helps with the immune function in the GI tract. Recap what we went over. We talked about zinc, vitamin C, vitamin A, vitamin D, and probiotics, and how research has associated the supplementation of these things with their immune boosting and antiviral properties. So, as always, before you start this supplementation, talk to your provider, make sure it's appropriate for you and more so safe for you. If you'd like to come see me, feel free, go to naturalmeddoc.com. You can schedule your free 15-minute phone consultation, or else just give us a call. Talk to us about what you are interested in. Also, if you are interested in ordering products that I personally recommend, check out our links below. Each one of these is linked down there. Before you go, if you like this video, make sure to subscribe below, leave me a comment, give me a like, and as always, live your best life.